Good morning, students. Good morning, grade 2. I know that you are all excited to learn, and let's get back to work. So in order for us to know the new lesson, we have to, of course, review in order for you to know and for us to be able to continue with our lessons. Now, we have here money. I know that you all know this one, but let's try to go over it first. So we have here, as we can say, we have dollar and cent. And we said before that dollar is greater than cent. Now we have here $1 is the same as 100 cent. And the sign for dollar is this one. And the sign for cent is this. Now in order for us to separate dollar and cent, we can use a decimal point. So for example, if we are going to separate $6 and 30 cents, then we can write it as 6.30, or we are going to read this as $6.30. Now we cannot be able to use two signs together. So if you are going to use dollar, it should only be dollar. And if you are going to use cents, then it should only be cents. Now we have here some examples. So let's try to convert. First, we have here cent to dollar. So example, we have 250 cents. Okay, so in order for you not to be confused, then you can get 200 cents first plus $50. Why did I separate it this way? It's because 200 cents is equivalent to $2 as a whole plus 50 cents. And like what we said, in order for us to separate dollars and cents, we have to use a decimal point. So it will be $2 and the decimal point, 50 cents. Okay, now the opposite, we have converting dollar to cent. So if we have here $5.95, then we are going to separate both of this. So $5 plus 95 cents. Now what is the equivalent of $5? If you're going to convert it to cent, it will be 500 cents. And then just copy 95 cents. You add them together, then you will get 595 cents. We have here more examples. So we have here 520 cents. 520 cents, we are going to write whole numbers first. So we have here 500 cents, okay? Because if you are going to convert this to dollar, it will be $5. Plus this one, which is 20 cents. So all you need to do is to copy it here, 20 cents. And if you're going to write it as a whole, then you're going to use only the dollar sign. So we have $5, decimal point, and 20 cents. Next one, we also have $3.25. So we are going to convert it to cents. We have here, separate the dollar, $3, and then we have here the cents, which is 25 cents. And then, oops. So $3 is 300 cents, and then just copy 25 cents, add them together, and you will have 325 cents. Okay, so that's it for converting dollar to cents and then cents to dollar. Now let's try to compare the amount of money. So we have here example. So this is a exactly. This is a watermelon. This is not a ball. This is an apple. Okay, so for the watermelon, it costs $2.95. And for the apple, it costs $3. And as we all know, guys, dollar is greater than cents. So this is only for $2.95, and this is for $3. So watermelon costs $95, while apple costs $3. And $3 is more than $2.95. And $2.95 is less than $3. So the apple costs more than the watermelon because this is for $3 and this is for $2.95. So that's it for today, and I'll be posting some worksheets and I'll be asking you guys to answer your workbook as well. So I hope you have a great time, and thank you for listening.